Blood smears may be used to identify blood disorders and blood-borne parasites. At the end of this lab, students will be able to distinguish between blood cells and blood-borne parasites. As well, they will be able to distinguish between the blood-borne parasites Plasmodium species and Trypanosoma species. Plasmodium falciparum is a protozoan organism that causes malaria. There are more than 200 million cases of malaria worldwide and about 500,000 deaths every year. There are multiple species of Plasmodium that cause malaria, and they can often be distinguished from the blood smear, but you are not expected to distinguish between different species of Plasmodium. Plasmodium is transmitted by anopheles mosquitoes and have a complicated life cycle. Female mosquitoes take a blood meal from an infected person and take up the parasite with the blood meal. The parasite attaches to the mosquito gut wall and undergoes part of its life cycle there, and the next stage then travels to the salivary glands. If a mosquito takes another blood meal after that, the parasites are introduced into the human bloodstream. For this lab, you do not need to know all the different life stages of the pathogen. This will be covered separately in the lecture portion of this course. Once Plasmodium species are introduced into the human bloodstream, the parasites invade the cells of the liver and undergo another part of their life cycle. About 2 weeks later, the next stage of the parasite is released into the bloodstream, and it is this stage that invades red blood cells. The parasites then become trophozoites, also known as the ring stage, which is easily identified on a human blood smear and used to diagnose the disease. Roughly every 2 to 3 days, the parasites burst out of the red blood cells all at the same time in the early evening, right around the time that mosquitoes are active. They can then be taken up by female mosquitoes taking a blood meal, and the cycle starts again. Malaria results in alternating high fever and chills. The burst red blood cells cause anemia, and the increase in dead blood cells overwhelm the liver, resulting in jaundice and dark-colored urine. It is the latter that earns malaria the nickname black water fever. Malaria is diagnosed from blood smears. Start by observing a prepared slide with Plasmodium falciparum on a blood smear at 100-fold magnification. Then increase the magnification to 400-fold. The parasite can be identified as the purple-stained ring form inside the red blood cells, and the red blood cells will appear pinkish red in your slide.